people who were in a dormitory at a university in Madrid, and they started harassing through their windows women who were in another dormitory literally across the alley. Watch this. Okay, so for those of you who don't know Spanish, these were students at Elías Ahúja, an all-male college, which is part of the University of Madrid. They staged this display from the windows on Sunday shouting, "Whores, come out of your burrows like rabbits, you are F nymphomaniacs. I promised you all F in the bullfight, go Ahúja." The students then proceed to appear across different windows across the building en masse facing Santa Monica, the women's accommodation nearby, and they continue yelling. Spain, because Spain has outlawed catcalling in an attempt to protect women's sexual rights this past May, these males, these boys, are now facing some pretty big repercussions. Spain's laws against rape and sexual assault have been the subject of fierce protests by feminist groups in recent years. After a long campaign, the law was changed to yes means yes rule, whereby staying silent during a rape could never be seen as consent after a string of high profile cases where attackers got off with light sentences. But again, in response to that, there is this new effort to try to make sure that people also don't intimidate and yell things to intimidate and harass women. But this again wasn't just a few people, this was an entire male dorm of more than 100 students who clearly had organized and practiced and figured out, okay, how can we all join together and make this harassment particularly intimidating for the women's dorm, and how can we do something that will get everybody's attention? And then somebody else said, oh yeah, maybe it should be videotaped so we can show everybody how coordinated we are. What a bunch of idiots, never mind the fact that they're misogynistic, and every culture has them, but Dan, I mean, you know, what does a university do with something like this?
Yeah, well, definitely university reprimands. They luckily made it all convenient that it's an all boys dorm, that everyone did this. They all have windows. You can easily track and figure out which rooms were involved in it. And definitely the university should reprimand them if they don't want to be seen as the type of place where this kind of thing can happen. But it's definitely sort of shocking, just like you described, David, how top to bottom there was coordination, there was planning, there were probably practices. And they wanted to demonstrate, hey, these are the type of men we want to show the world that we are. This is the type of misogyny that we want to represent. And by the way, ladies, this is how we think and this is what we're proud of. I can't imagine something as self-defeating and shooting yourself in the foot as having participated in one of these videos. But thankfully, it wasn't one of those new like iPhone Pro super zoom lenses, so you can't see any faces. So maybe some people will be able to say, oh, I was actually getting pizza at that time. So I actually wasn't involved in that. I disagree with the whole thing, so I made an excuse. But it's absolutely disgusting behavior.
It is disgusting. And thankfully, the Prime Minister of Spain is showing some leadership on this. Pedro Sanchez has called on all politicians and media outlets, saying that we need to give a united and common message of rejection of these machista behaviors, which are unexplainable, unjustifiable, and absolutely repugnant. Unfortunately, the chant is allegedly part of a ritual of machismo that takes place at the beginning of each academic year. TikToks from 2021 show how the song is part of a hazing process for newcomers, a mode of indoctrination. The university did not respond to the identical incident from last year. But this year, the administration released an Instagram statement on the matter. In it, the university calls the action unacceptable. At least one student, the so-called ringleader of the chant, has already been expelled for this incident, and the remaining students will be required to take courses for awareness in gender equality. And hopefully this is the last year of this ritual of machismo.